Hey, so you're looking to move to Cape Cod and you're not really sure what town. So today I want to discuss with you the town of Mashpee. So first of all, where is Mashpee located on Cape Cod? So if you're looking at Cape Cod at a map, Mashpee is located towards the bottom of Cape Cod. So it's next to Falmouth, Sandwich and Barnstable, and it's not on Cape Cod Bay. So there are no beaches in Mashpee that are along Cape Cod Bay. They're at the bottom where you have Nantucket Sound, Martha's Vineyard, and Nantucket. So Mashpee has a population of a little over 15,000 year-round residents as of 2020. And it's also the home of the Mashpee Wampanoag tribe. So the Mashpee Wampanoag tribe has about 2,600 enrolled citizens. So it is the site of the headquarters of that tribe. So it's a pretty cool town, actually, to live in because it's very unique in that aspect. The median household income between 2017 and 2021 was a little over $83,000. And now we're going to get a little bit into the real estate portion. So last year, the average sale price was $975,000. And the property tax rate in the town of Mashpee is $7.42 per thousand. The average square footage of a property in Mashpee as of 2022 was just over 2,000 square feet. And so, as you make your way through the town of Mashpee, if you explore the entire town, you will notice that real estate can definitely range as far as the style of houses, the size of houses, and it greatly depends on what part of Mashpee that you're in. So there are some higher end neighborhoods in Mashpee. So there is a country club where there are some properties that is called Willow Bend. So Willow Bend is a golf course community. It is a gated community. And the houses in there are beautiful. There are condos as well as single family homes as well. It is a beautifully landscaped area. I'll show you a quick little clip here, and you'll see that it's very well maintained. So, golf courses, if you love to golf, if you're looking to be in a gated community, then Willow Bend is definitely a place that you should think about. We also have New Seabury. So New Seabury is an exclusive resort community. So there are a lot of homes in New Seabury. They go from condos to single family homes along the ocean. They are still building down there as well. So if you're looking for something that's about $800,000 plus, then this may be an area for you to check out. They have a wide range of amenities in New Seabury. So there is a golf course. There is a beach club. So you also have, along with the golf course, you have a country club. There is the beach. So there's Pompanesset Beach. We also have the Pompanesset Inn, which is a gorgeous hotel style place where there are weddings and functions, and it's absolutely gorgeous. When you pull into the building area, right along the front entrance, if you look straight through those front doors, you can actually see the ocean. So, Pompanesset Inn sits right along the beach. I actually had my prom there, so it really is a beautiful place. The entire little village of Pompanesset is completely beautifully landscaped as well. That is one thing that they definitely take pride in. So New Seabury basically is a village of Mashpee, but it is a luxury location. The next beach is South Cape Beach, and it is a pretty long beach. It has a nice stretch of ocean. You can, of course, you can swim, you can fish. You do have to pay to park during the summer months. I believe it is a little more expensive for non-residents. I want to say it's about $40 for non-residents and $25 for residents. So if you want to spend a relaxing day at the beach, you definitely want to check out South Cape Beach. But if you don't like swimming in the salt water, and if you're afraid of sharks, which are can tend to be a little bit popular in the area on Cape Cod, then you might want to check out Mashpee Wakebee Pond. So Mashpee Wakebee Pond is basically two ponds that are connected. So part of the pond is in Sandwich and part of the pond is in Mashpee. So it's a little over 700 acres and you can have a boat. So motorized boats are allowed in the pond. Fishing, swimming, there are nice luxury style homes that are all around this pond as well. And there is a little parking area in Mashpee that you can park there if you want to hang out by the pond for the day. It is a little sandy area. I believe they do have a lifeguard on certain days of the week over there as well. What's also cool about the town of Mashpee is they have a community garden. So there are some volunteers that go to maintain this garden. So it's more of a vegetable garden, but it's really nice to see the community come together and just put something nice like that in the town. So if shopping is one of your favorite things to do, you probably should check out Mashpee Commons. So Mashpee Commons is one of a kind. There are all different types of shops there. They have over 100 businesses in Mashpee Commons. They also have about 77 residential units as well. And they range from different shops, gift shops. They have L.L. Bean. They have the Black Dog. There's Sunglass Hut. There's a few restaurants in there that are very good. There's Bobby Burns. So basically you can shop and you can dine in Mashpee Commons. There's also a fitness studio. They have entertainment there and there's some cafes as well. Mashpee Commons also has a lot of year-round events. So whether it's Christmas time during the winter months or it's summertime, there's always something going on at Mashpee Commons. So if you do decide to move to Mashpee, you're going to want to know where the local grocery stores are. And there are three that are pretty popular. So we have Stop and Shop, which is pretty popular around the area. That is located right by the Mashpee Rotary. We also have Roach Brothers, which is located on Route 28. It's right off of Route 28, so it's also very close by Mashpee Commons. And then we also have Rory's Market and Kitchen, and that is actually located in Mashpee Commons. So all three of these stores are located very closely around Mashpee Commons. You will notice that that is more of a popular little area in the town of Mashpee. And then there are some other restaurants that are not in Mashpee Commons. There's Cook's Seafood, and we also have the 99 restaurant as well. And for the kids, there is the Children's Museum. So the Children's Museum puts a lot of different activities together for kids. There's a lot of different events. So it's definitely a good place to check out. And they have different people that are teaching over there every week. They have a whole schedule on their website. So that is also something that if it's maybe a rainy day or something like that and you can't go to the beach, you should check out the Children's Museum. Around Mashpee Wakeby Pond are lots of walking trails as well. So Mashpee is pretty well known for walking trails. If you are someone that likes to explore and learn about some new places, there are some walking trails all around the pond, and there are some additional walking trails that are not around the pond. And a great way to find out where those trails are is you want to check out the app. It's called All Trails. I have it downloaded myself. And it'll really show you different trails in the area, how far away they are from you, and also how long the trail is as well. So if you don't want to do something that's a 3-mile trail and you'd rather do something a little bit shorter, you can also find out where the shorter trails are. So the All Trails app is definitely something that I would recommend that you download, especially if you like to explore. And that goes for every town on the Cape as well. So I hope this helps you get to know the town of Mashpee a little bit better. There are a lot more things to discover. And if you ever have any questions, or if you're looking for a buyer's agent to help you with your home buying process on Cape Cod, I would be happy to help. In the meantime, feel free to check out some of our other videos if you're looking to explore some other towns on Cape Cod. And I will see you in the next one. So thank you so much for watching. Feel free to like and hit that bell to subscribe. I will be uploading some new videos, and you will definitely want to learn more about living on Cape Cod.